is for this age group the most effective kind of digital literacy. We've partnered with online child connection specialists like Chris Finney to ensure our audience's safety, and we'll provide parents with information to help them discuss these issues with their kids. When it comes to young people, though, I think we all need to remember this simple fact. Adults need directions when they get something new, and kids do not. We created our childhoods within the cultural institutions that were available at the time. Many of us in this room remember when educational social institutions and mainstream media defined social context. Young people do not. They're playing at a time when social contacts and entertainment and casual learning experiences are constantly being created, used, and then recreated in new images. For years, we've talked about the digital divide in this business, and we've meant access, haves and have-nots. While that hasn't been completely solved, I think we're well on our way to addressing that. Now I think the digital divide is a generational issue. It's like languages. As long as I study Spanish, I will never have the fluency of a native speaker. As long as I explore digital media, I will never have the fluency my children do. I respect and participate in the ongoing discussions about the influence on young people's development of digital media, and I agree that roadmaps need to be in place to ensure safety and to guide usage. But in the same way that we know that once our kids hit middle school, we need to set them free to roam the messy realities of our local communities, we also need to find ways to allow autonomy and exploration within the digital landscape. As the physical nature of our towns and cities act as boundaries, we need to define natural boundaries for children's activities in media space that acknowledge their self-determination. We need to legitimize new forms of contact between adults and kids in the domain of play. The U.S. cultural institution that I respect as being on the cutting edge of figuring all this out are the public libraries. More than schools, more than museums, more than parks, libraries are reinventing themselves as the new public square, the new gathering place. They're offering personal and technology-driven access to community writ large. It's libraries who encourage free access to information. They're hosting MMOG clubs, gaming tournaments, and RPGs. Librarians are on the vanguard in this quest to explore the digital world in their audience's best interests. As you watch kids play in libraries now, whether they're making costumes for an RPG or reading graphic novels, or you see older kids teaching younger ones how to play a game or draw manga, you quickly see that given the space, the time, and a reasonable set of needs, young people will continue the tradition of creating their own versions of childhood with the cultural resources they have at hand. Thank you.
Wow. Well, that was a terrific jumping-off point for, I hope, a very interesting conversation. So a lot of things have come up just in these little presentations the speakers have done, and I'd like to revisit some of them and then open up to your questions. I hope you guys will feel free to interrupt each other and discuss amongst yourselves. I think that's going to produce the most interesting conversation here. So let's just first pick up on what Alice is talking about, and I'm going to address this to all of you. You know, there's no question that you're dealing with an immigrant generation and a native generation here, and that parents, by and large, are not fluent in this technology, nor are they able to immerse themselves to the level that their children are. The reality is that I think it puts parents in a tender position when we're talking about this tween teenage group, because there is still the sense that you want to control what your kids are doing to a certain extent online and protect them. And of course, the realization that you can't possibly go there. You don't know this space the way they will, and you never will. So I'm curious about how each of you are wrestling with this issue, about who controls this space, about how to involve parents in a space so that they're able to continue to be parents. Play the role parents need to. Does any of you want to speak first? Okay, Larry, nothing? There you go.
I think it's such an important point, and the notion that, and we see that today, right, that kids